Welcome to today's broadcast and God bless you. I'm reading from the book of Psalm chapter 1 and verse number 2 in the King James Version. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night. The last 2 days of this week, we've seen how studying the Word of God is so important to you. To us as a believer. And that study makes the scripture very, very beautiful. But then I'm going to go a little bit higher today to go into the next thing you do with the Word of God. Don't forget the other week you read the Word of God, and this week we're talking about studying the Word of God. But the third one is the most important. It's called meditation. Yeah, meditation is like when you have brought your ingredient home and you want to cook a pot of soup, and then you mix them together. When you buy them, that's like reading the scripture. When you mix them together, put them together to grind them, that's study. You're studying. When you begin to put it inside a pot, that is meditation. You're putting everything together. Meditation is your attitude or your action after you have read and studied the Word of God. To take it from the book, take it from the app or from where you're reading it and begin to think about it. I like you to hear that. So think about it. So I like to start by explaining what is meditation. Meditation is to focus one mind for a period of time in silence over a particular truth. That is the dictionary definition of meditation. To focus. You could close your eyes, you could open it, and somebody is talking around you, you don't even know they are talking. Why? You are meditating on the Word of God. Until you get to that point where you can think, where you can ponder. I have some synonyms here. Where you can muse, where you can ponder, you can ruminate, you can regurgitate, to consider, where you can examine attentively and deliberately. That's when you are meditating. And the scripture here said, meditating must be day and night. We have a lot of prayer warrior who don't sleep at night, but we fully have meditation warrior. Your prayer, I want to say it again, is at the mercy of the world. Every prayer outside God's word is blah, blah. You're wasting your time. They will never be answered. So, meditation makes your prayer life quality. Because the word will become flesh to you. You meditate on it day and night. Now, I want you to see the first advantage of that meditation in verse number 3 of that Psalm chapter number 1. He said, and it shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. What makes the word of God planted in your life is meditation. It goes into your vein. It travels into your marrow. It becomes a profiting word of God unto you because in meditation, you know, you have been able to absorb it. You've been able to take it in. That is when the word become what God has said it will become. It said, it shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water and bringeth forth its fruit and arises it. The word of God can only be fruitful because it's a seed at the mercy of meditation. His leaves shall not wither. What will not make your life wither is the meditation. It's not just the reading. It's not just the study. And whatsoever you do, it shall prosper. So the prosperity of the word is at the meditation of the word. And you know what? We have so many Christians who read scripture, who study scripture, who don't meditate on the scripture. I want to ask you that you begin your journey. If you need 15 minutes a day to read the word of God, then you need, I bet you, nothing less than 20 minutes a day. In fact, every opportunity you have, either in the office, either you're driving, either you're in the toilet, either you're in your kitchen, to think a word and make that word, it's like you having your perfume on top of your table. You spray it. The word of God is sprayed into your being at the level of meditation. Of course, it's the secret of everything about the word of God. I want you to write it under this video. Until you begin to meditate on the word cannot profit you. God bless you. See you tomorrow.